Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss the distribution of d electrons in high and low spin in an octahedral complex. In last lecture we have seen about the crystal space splitting in an octahedral complex. Also we have seen the points known as high field complex and low field complex, of which ligands are called as high spin ligand and low spin ligands. Today I am going to discuss out of 10 d electrons, what is the arrangement of d electrons in T2g and eg orbitals in an octahedral complex. So see one by one, for d electrons that is equal to from 1 to 10 electrons. Okay, I will draw some diagram and then I will discuss about the crystal field stabilization energy in case of high field and low field spin. Okay, now here d electrons, for d is equal to 1, here 1 2 3 4, and last is but 1 5. Okay, d orbitals, 3 d metal and orbital, 1 2 3 4. This portion is called as, left side is called as high spin, that is in short called as HS, and here of low spin, that is called as in short LS. Okay, in high spin, in case of a octahedral complex, here the number of which orbitals are pointing towards in octahedral complex, that is of eg orbitals, okay, and here of t2g orbitals. Okay, now one must care should be taken that in high spin complex orbitals there is a energy gap that is equal to very small. Okay, these are the t2g orbitals. Okay, and these are for low spin, here energy gap is very large. For that purpose we can draw here as these are the t2g, these are the eg orbitals. Okay, now which are the t2g? That is dxy, dyz and dxz. Then which are the eg orbitals are here? Which are the dx square minus y square and dz square. Okay, likewise here also dx square minus y square and dz square, dxy, dyz, dxz. This energy gap is large. Okay, here in high spin complex, small energy gap. Now for d is equal to 1 electron, okay, for d is equal to 1 electron, according to Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, in which complex? High spin complex, one of the electron can enter in these A2G low energy orbitals. Also here also in low spin complex, one of the electron is entering in low T2G orbitals. Therefore the net crystal field stabilization energy is calculated by the formula by using the pairing energy along with the number of electrons present in EG orbitals and number of electrons present in T2G orbitals, or in other words we can easily say that in octahedral complexes, eg orbitals are raised with higher energy. At that moment, T2g orbitals are lowered by the sum of the energy. Which is this energy? That is, eg is equal to plus 0.6 delta O, and here minus 0.4 delta octahedral. Okay, therefore, we can calculate this crystal field stabilization energy that is equal to CFSE, okay, not a net crystal CFSE. In net CFSE, we have the another formula here. What is the formula? That is number of electrons in each orbitals, that is 0.6 into what? Number of unpaired electrons in each orbital plus minus 0.4 into number of unpaired electrons in T2g orbital. Now what are the electrons in eg orbitals? Here for this eg orbital, how many electrons? That is eg is equal to 0 in both the cases. T2g is equal to what? T2g is equal to 1 electron. Got it? Therefore putting this value, therefore we get, that is 0.6 into 0, okay, plus minus 0.4 into 1, okay. What is the net answer? I will take here some space and give the answer here as, here CFSE is equal to what? That is 0.6 into 0, 0, 0 plus minus 0.4 delta O, okay. Therefore, minus 0.4 delta O, okay. What is the CFSE? That is equal to, for high spin and low spin, the two values are, that is crystal field stabilization energy are L is equal to minus 0.4 delta octahedral, okay. In case of DQ, what happens? Just we have to multiply into 10, that is equal to minus 4 DQ. DQ means differential of quanta. There are two units. First is delta octahedral or differential of quanta. You may can use any of this. That is, one delta octahedral is equal to 10 into delta octahedral is equal to DQ. Okay? Okay? Okay. Now, for D2 electrons, okay? Now, for D2 electrons, see here, D2, here T2G electrons, and here EG electrons. Gap equal to small, therefore it is called as high spin. Your gap is equal to large, therefore these are called as low spin. These are EG, these are T2G. This gap is very large. Okay, now this is equal to low spin. In short, it is called as LS. And in between here, we can draw or we can calculate the crystal field stabilization energy for low spin and here high spin. Okay, now for D2 electrons, according to Horn's rule of maximum multiplicity, the two electrons can enter in lowest energy level, that is equal to this T2G. Okay, and already for octahedral complex, we know that these values is equal to, these energy levels are decreased by how many units? That is minus 2 by 5, it is equal to minus 0.4, and here increased by plus 0.6. Okay. What is about in high and low spin complex? That is equal to, two electrons are also entered in low energy T2G orbitals. Now, what is the high spin and low spin crystal field stabilization energy? Here, as the two electrons can enter in lowest T2g orbitals, therefore T CFAC for both the high spin and low spin is equal to same. Therefore, CFAC is equal to what? That is, here Eg is equal to 0.6 into number of electrons, how many? That is equal to 0 plus minus 4.4 into how many electrons? That is equal to 2. Therefore, the net answer will be 0 plus minus 0.8, that is equal to minus 0.8 delta octet hedral, that is equal to minus 8 dp. Okay, now the third case is about, that is of D3. Okay, here just I am replacing the electrons by 2/3. What is the case? D3. What is the electron distribution here according to Hund's rules of maximum multiplicity? That is equal to 3 electrons. Here also 3 electrons. Again, the CFAC is comes to be a same value. That is equal to CFAC is equal to what? That is plus 0.6 into number of electrons. How many? That is equal to 0 minus 0.4 into number of electrons. How many is equal to 3? Okay. Therefore, is equal to 0 plus minus 1.2. Okay. Therefore, is equal to minus 1.2 delta octahedral. Okay. That is equal to minus 12 dq. That is, from D1 to D3, we can easily say that the CFAC value for D1 to D3 is equal to same. Which same? That is crystal field stabilization energy. It is decrease in energy of a central metal ion due to the energy levels, that is of high energy level and low energy levels. Okay. Now come to the most important configuration, that is equal to 4. What is about 4 configuration? See here. Now, number of electrons D4 is equal to what? That is equal to 4 electrons. Now, what is the electron distribution according to Hund's rule? According to Hund's rule, here in high spin, as the energy gap is very very small, here first 3 electrons are entered as in this fashion, fourth electron due to small energy gap, this can be entered to first Eg orbitals. But in the high spin complex, low spin complex, what happens? Here the 3 electrons are already entered in this fashion, but due to the very large energy gap between Eg and T2g orbitals, electron cannot possess the higher energy. Therefore, it can pair with the remaining T2g orbitals, that is in opposite sign, that is equal to this fashion. Therefore, without entering to higher energy orbital, it can again pair with the unpaired electrons. Therefore, T2g electrons, number of electrons are how many? That is equal to 4. Okay. And here number of electrons in high spin is equal to 3. Therefore, CFAC value R gets are different. Okay. In CFAC, in high spin complex, that is equal to value, that is equal to plus 0.6 into how many electrons? 1 plus minus 0.4 into how many electrons? 3. Therefore, the answer will be prime 0.6 minus 1.2, that is equal to minus 0.6 delta octahedron, that is equal to minus 6 dq. But in crystal field stabilization energy for high spin complex, what is the crystal field stabilization energy for high spin complex? That is equal to this. See here, that is Eg orbitals, that is 0.6 into 0 plus minus 0.4 into how many electrons here? That is equal to how many electrons? That is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, therefore the answer should be minus 1.6. Okay, that is equal to minus 1.6 delta octahedral, that is equal to minus 16 dq. Thus, from the configuration D4 to D7, here the change in crystal field stabilization energy can occur. Okay, due to high spin and low spin complexes and due to energy gap between the Eg and T2g orbitals is very very small in high spin and very very large in low spin complexes. Now let us see about D5 configuration. Okay, what is this? Okay, D5. Already we have written in D4. Okay, for high spin complex, what is the condition? D4 or D5? 1, 2, 3 or 5. What is here? Again, here pairing should be start here. It is equal to 5. Now, what is the crystal restoration energy in this here? What we have to write here? That is LS. 1.6 into how many electrons? That is equal to 2 electrons. Okay. Plus minus 0.4 into how many electrons? That is equal to also a 3 electrons. Therefore, total should be 1.2 minus 1.2. Okay. Here 0.6 into 2, 1.2. 0.4 into 3, 1.2. That is equal to 0 octahedral. Okay. And 0 into 10 is equal to 0 dq. Okay. That is crystal restoration energy is equal to 0. Okay. Now, what is this? 0.6 into 2 and 0.4 into minus 0.4 into 3. What is about in high spin complex? That is equal to the formula. Same formula here. We can use here. 0.6 into how many electrons? 0. Okay. Plus minus 0.4 into how many electrons? 5. That is equal to 0 plus minus 0.2.0 octahedral. That is equal to minus 2. That is equal to 2.0 delta octahedral. That is equal to minus 20 dq. Okay, here now for D6, what is the configuration? See here for D6, just we have to increase the electrons here for D6. For D6, please concentration on here. In high spin complex, after entering one electron in each orbital, now the pairing of the electrons is can start in high spin complex, that is from here. That is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This is about D6. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What about this? Here also, last should be the pairing is completed. Thus, there is completely filling of T2G orbital with pairing of electrons. Now, what is the CFAC high spin complex? That is equal to 0.6, okay, into how many electrons? 2, okay, plus minus 0.4 into how many electrons? Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. Therefore, the answer should be 1.2 minus 1.6. That is equal to minus 0.4 delta octahedral. That is equal to minus 4 dq. Okay. This should be in high spin. What is about low spin? Here low spin is equal to CFSC is equal to what? That is 0.6 into what value? Eg is equal to 0 plus minus 0.4 into what value? That is equal to 6 electrons. Okay. Therefore, the CFSC is equal to 0. Plus minus 2.4, that is equal to minus 2.4 dq, delta octahedral, that is equal to minus 24 dq. Okay, in this fashion we have explained about the splitting of d orbitals in low spin and high spin complex. But one question arises is that, see here, from d4 to d8, from D4 to D10, here in low spin complexes, in low spin and high spin complexes, pairing of electron can take place. Takes place according to Horn's rule of maximum multiplicity. Therefore, for especially for low spin, that is equal to for D4, is equal to what is the configuration? That is, these are the eg orbitals. These are the T2g orbitals here. 1, 2 and 3 here. Due to low spin, that is this energy gap is equal to very very large, therefore electrons get paired up into here. For that purpose, this electron pair we have to count it as, for pairing of the electron, it requires the energy. And that energy is called as nothing but the pairing energy. Okay, what energy? That is equal to a pairing energy. Therefore, the formula for CFSC is equal to a net CFSC. Net CFSC is equal to, what is this formula? That is plus 0.6 into number of unpaired electrons in Eg, okay, plus minus 0.4 into number of unpaired electrons in T2g plus pairing energy means what? That is number of electrons which are paired one. That is for this D4, this P is equal to what value? That is equal to 1. Okay, that is one electron pair is seen. Thus, from D4 to D10, how the net CFSC can be calculated, we can see this point in the next lecture. Thank you.